Hey guys, here we are at SEMA 2019.
Well, let's get inside and check out all the rides. Well, guys, we're back from SEMA. So I've gone through all the pics, video, everything we've taken, and I've come out with my top five picks. Now, these are my picks. They're not what you might decide, but I have my reasons why I choose this top five. So let's get into it. Well, guys, the first one here is an import. Now, you don't normally see me talk that much about imports. I work on them from time to time, but they're not something I normally showcase. Now, this guy here, there's a reason why they left the body off. They did not finish putting the body on. It's to showcase their work. I met the welder while I was there, and I mean, I had to shake his hand. He did an amazing job with all the welds and the fabrication. Now, he told me he didn't do the CNC work because all the arms are aluminum CNC'd. But all the rest of the steel work he did, and he did a great job. Now this guy's even got a cantilever suspension on it with coilovers, so it lays really low. But great job, guys. That's why you're one of my top five picks. Well, this build here, now this build is up my alley. This is my style. He's done everything himself, completely custom. A lot of people are just going nuts about the blown motor, but if you look closely, there's a lot of items he made himself. The exhaust, for one, it looks like running boards. It's not. It's actually four exhaust pipes on each side. Now, these really small mufflers in them, and I went and talked to him, and turns out they're Harley mufflers he's using. And they look real streamlined. They look great. Now, in the interior, he went very steampunk with it. There's lots of copper, things like that. That's awesome. That's his way of building. That's what he liked to do. But I can appreciate the craftsmanship in it. Everything was handmade. Awesome job. You might notice this next truck. This one here is built by Jesse James. I've been following the build on Instagram. I got to see it in person. And I have to say, it takes the beauty of the fabrication, the TIG welding, everything else mixed with functionality. This truck could take a beating and go all day long. It's an amazing freaking truck. But if you walk around it and really take the time to look at it, you'll see the little details. Everything down to the taillights. I mean, everything's fabricated and everything is just attention to detail. So this International caught me off guard. I'm walking by and I notice it. I'm like, no, it's another off-road build. But then I start looking closely. It's got a Cummins diesel in it. They body sectioned it. You can see where they moved the fenders up front and rear. They chop topped it. I mean, I just appreciate the work in this. I never would have thought the chop top and section of off-road build. And I went through it and I was looking at it, and I actually have videos of them mobbing this thing through mud and everything else. So it's actually a functional truck, but I can appreciate the fabrication and extra steps they did on the body work. Now my last pick is a 1966 C10 pickup. Now what makes this different than every other C10 build you see is it's got a 2.8 diesel crate motor in it. Now, it's built by Metalox and Johnny G. They're both local to Phoenix, Arizona, and I've seen them around many times. This truck is custom from top to bottom, except for the paint. The paint's actually true patina. Now, a lot of you guys go, no way, the doors have red primer, the bed has black primer. If the parts came out of different plants, you use different color primer. This truck is custom from top to bottom. Now, United Pacific asked me to come by, take a look at the truck. I went through it, and you guys will be seeing another video of nothing but this truck. So, that's why this guy's my last pick. Well, guys, that's our 2019 SEMA trip. Now, we saw thousands of cars, and we took at least 1,000 photos. I'm not going to sit here and bombard you guys with a huge slideshow. Hopefully, you guys like the ones I put up. If you want to see more, go to our Instagram or our Facebook. Pretty simple, Broke Bastard Garage. And you can see lots of other pics, things we're going to be posting up throughout the month. So, all right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. We'll see you on the next one.